Well, I've just come out of the House of Commons, having had a very encouraging conversation with my Member of Parliament, John Smith. We do go back a few years. I've been honoured him about the subjects of malfeasance by people with positions of privilege. I'm talking about the law courts, I'm talking about the police, I'm talking about the legal profession. He is going to look into three things. I didn't crowd him. I've asked him to look into three things. This investigation that I found out that is going on by the Attorney General to have me certified as a vexatious litigant. 7 years they have had a team of lawyers here in Whitehall, down here beside Downing Street, to see whether I can be banned from British law courts for life. He's going to look into that, because the internal memo that's been leaked to me from a certain Her Majesty's Court Service Department clearly shows secretaries between government departments asking, ordering that defendants in my cases, the Royal College of Veterinary Surgeons and the South Wales Police, be contacted to be informed of what's going on and to hand over any information, evidence, relating to my activities. Quite out of order. The second thing that he has promised to look into is that my complaint to the police commission investigating, I forget what they call it, IPCC, investigating my complaints about the conduct of the police, when I've made complaints of perjury, I've made complaints of failure to investigate crime, all sorts of things. They have come back with nothing. There's a clear indication that they have not investigated my complaint. Now that's another government department. The third department is under the Data Protection Act. I was advised years ago to make the Royal College of Veterinary Surgeons in Horse Ferry Road, just around the corner here, to hand over investigation documents that they did not disclose when they managed in 2001, on May the 29th, Oak Apple Day, to have my name removed from the register for life. And the Information Commissioner for the Data Protection Act has ruled that the investigation into whether I should go before a court to have my name removed is confidential and was classified as legal professional privilege. Now this is exactly the argument the Attorney General has used and the Home Secretary has used when I took them to court a few weeks ago in Cardiff County Court. The Treasury Solicitor's barrister said, we are not obliged to give you anything to do with the investigation that's been going on for 7 years. It stinks. It really stinks. Because it seriously affected my claim for damages against the South Wales Police. And this very week, would you believe, Barbara Wilding, the chief of the South Wales Police, is writing a sworn affidavit that she has and her police have no knowledge of how I was put into Cardiff Prison on the pretext I couldn't be identified. They used a sledgehammer and a crowbar with a team load of police, one a sergeant, and broke into my surgery to put a girl into my flat who just happened to be the daughter of a police inspector back into a flat that they weren't paying no rent for, and there was a suggestion of drugs being used. And the third issue that is going on this week is that the police have denied knowledge of court cases that I have won. And the magistrates have written to say they have destroyed all evidence. But I have the witnesses. I have the names of the police who took photographs of my car and took me to court for no tax and no MOT. Happened to be a veterinary ambulance licensed in a Channel Island, for Pete's sake. That is how... And here I am under the shadow of dear old Winnie. And... I wonder what Sir Winston would think of this. Anyway, my young son is coming to meet us, and we're going to have a meal. and I'm going to have to ask him, Alex, what do you make of all this? Is the world going crazy or is it me going crazy? Okay, I'll talk to you later. Okay.